38 years and counting, onward and upward, Nicole. That's the important thing. Diabetes can be such an overwhelming 24-hour job. But this next story will show you just how far a great attitude can take you. Now, I'm pretty pleased with myself for having survived 38 years with diabetes. But this 96-year-old man has been living with diabetes for almost 60 years. And I thought, here's a guy we should talk to.
My name is Robert J. Stewart, DPM. And I was born in 1912, and I've had diabetes for almost 60 years. Now, when I first had diabetes, I don't think the doctors knew a whole lot about it, but insulin was available, fortunately, and so the outlook was great that I could consider that I could have a pretty normal life.
Now, in all fairness, we should point out that Bob's idea of normal may be a little different than yours or mine.
When I was 65 years old, I decided to go in for the Senior Olympics. And I've had a great time every year doing that.
So we asked Bob for his secrets to staying fit and healthy.
I think the main thing they said was just eat a good, normal diet rather than any specific do's or don'ts. One of the main things I've gotten a hold of is flaxseed. 2 heaping tablespoons full of that every morning. Of course, white sugar is a no-no in my book. White bread is a no-no in my book. Exercise wasn't hard for me because I've always been active. People who are willing to eat right and exercise right and sleep right and have a good attitude, it was amazing how much better they were able to manage their diabetes.
Here was a guy who knows all the tricks, a guy who had learned to live well with his disease. There must be more people like him. There are. Dr. Sherry Kohlberg interviewed a slew of diabetes veterans and wrote a book about it.
What we did was interviewed more than 50 people who've lived long and well with both type 1 and type 2 diabetes and asked them, what were your secrets? I myself have had diabetes for 40 years and I wanted to know, what have they done?
Me too. What are the key ingredients to living long with diabetes? Well, according to Sherry's research, numbers 1 and 2 are no secret. Diet and exercise. Okay, 3 and 4 get a little trickier. Build your own team, be your own advocate. Very important. But number 5 is probably the most difficult, but it's what keeps people like Bob so vibrant and so healthy. And I think number 5 should be number 1, positive attitude.
If you say, this is something that I have to deal with, and I'm going to do the very best I can to deal with it in the proper way, you've already licked it before you started.
What was interesting about these people is that so many of them had adopted just a positive outlook on life. They always look for the silver lining. And yes, some of them have had complications, but they've just dealt with them and kept on going.
And when it comes to positive attitude, Bob Stewart says it best.
Some people say, well, how do you do it? I tell them that they need to have the proper attitude toward the disease, not saying, oh goodness, I'm a diabetic, I'm gonna quit living. But say, I'm a diabetic, I'm gonna do the things that are necessary to take care of it, and I'm gonna live and have a good time, lots of fun and enjoyment.
Oh yeah!
Have a good time, lots of fun and enjoyment. Bob Stewart is the living proof. So just say to yourself every day, hey, you, live your life, enjoy your life, because it is your diabetes life.